My mic sounds nice. Check one. My mic sounds nice. Check two. All right. So look, y'all, I know I'm running late tonight. Part of the reason I'm running late is because I coach on Tuesday nights. I coach speakers and our time ran over. So I was like, oh no. So I had to tell y'all I was going to run late. All right, cool. So let's get started. Of course, y'all already know. Let's ring my bell. All right. So my teachers, I just want you to know here at Extreme Teachers, what do? We empower teachers to discover, develop, and utilize their superpowers to transform students' lives around them. Let's get it, y'all. I'm be in and out like a robbery. Let's go. Remember to repost, tag a teacher, share. Let them know that we are here every night, Monday through Friday, 8 p.m. for the most part. Do me a favor. Go ahead. Hey, Janine, what's up? Go ahead and subscribe to my YouTube channel. So there you can get all of the Extreme Teacher videos that we do all during the week. So if you miss it, just go and subscribe. Janine will put the link in the chat for me. All right, let's go. So last time we were together, last night, we did powerful summer parent engagement strategies. That was pretty cool. Check the video out. It's on the YouTube page. All right, so tonight, real quick, your school needs flexible learning spaces. Why? Corporate is doing it, y'all. These kids will go from a traditional setting into corporate and freak out, all right? So help them. I don't care what grade you are in, because 9 out of 10, when they're doing their homework, they're doing anything, they're in a flexible learning space. And Google really took this to the next level with the way they were doing things. So let's go. You have to get that. I don't know what you mean. I upgraded. You got to tell me what that means, Janine. Tell me what that means. All right. So employees at small startups and large corporations are meeting in flexible office spaces to pitch ideas, troubleshoot, and seal multi-million dollar deals. So it only makes sense to incorporate flexible learning spaces into our schools as well. So redefine the space. I put a lot of stuff up here so y'all can screenshot. All right. So it says learning spaces should be pleasing, well-planned, and equipped with all the materials and resources necessary for active learning to occur. These spaces do not require sliding walls or dedicated collaboration space to be defined as flexible learning spaces. It could be anywhere. You can have beanbag chairs. You can have bar stools with high bar tape, all kinds of stuff. You could just be creative. The best person in the school to get all this stuff from, ask the custodian, because sometimes they throw away stuff because it used to be 4 pieces, now it's 3. So you could just start grabbing little pieces and putting them in your room. That's how I redid the teacher's lounge at my old school. All right, this one, I love this one. I'm going to repost this one. So redefine space. What are we talking about? Flexible space that can be easily adjusted to meet and support learning activities. Allow for movement. Allow for various grouping. Allow for hands-on exploring, making, and building. And then it also says allow for curriculum integration, including arts, support social interaction and development, support cognitive skills and development, support the integration of technology, provide opportunities for students to learn through examples. Flexible, allow, support, provide. It says right there. So you're allowing things to happen and you're going to be supportive and then you're going to provide. Come on, y'all. Flexible seating, flexible learning spaces, promote collaboration. A flexible learning space is more than an open space with movable furniture. That is more than that. So have different styles, different types. I never understood the teachers that would let the kids like lay and read, but now I do. I value that. All right. Promote collaboration. Think of the benefits of providing a space that is part of that collaborative process, a space that will foster decision making, creativity, and communicating. They feel more relaxed. They do. So you can teach the traditional way, but then if you're brainstorming or you're doing some other kind of things, switch it up. All right. In flexible learning spaces, students spent more time collaborating and interacting. So think about it, right? They said students spent more time collaborating and interacting positively with their peers, as well as more time presenting work back to the class. Think about it. They're back there chopping it up. They're talking. And if you do it right, they won't be back there tearing up and playing. Further, students spent less time being taught explicitly and working individually than in traditional classrooms. So let's stop pushing tradition, 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 and push exposure, learning, and collaboration. I'm not going to tarry. Look. So, yeah, so we have comments over here. Hey, Constance. What's up, Connie? Flexible learning space. Yes, we need that. Yes. Oh, she watching the replay. So here's this. Yes. You have to do that. You have to change it up. This is what I do for my students. So think about it. Even if you were on Zoom, you could put them in different breakout sessions and change the energy in there or what the assignment is and rotate. Come on. Stop it. Stop it. I know we on hybrid learning. We on all of that, but let's do something that's pretty cool and that's fun to do. All right. So I'm not tarrying tonight. That's it. That's all. Check it out. I just wanted y'all to think about the benefits of flexible seating, because a lot of times I have quite a few veterans that follow me and listen to what I'm saying, but we have to not be so traditional all of the time. We have to come outside of that so we can connect. They're not just going to come sit in the seats and do what you say do. No, they're not. They're not. All kids don't come ready to learn. We can cross our fingers. We can, you know, whatever, but they're not coming ready to learn. So we have to have an environment that's conducive to learning and encouraging them to want to learn. All right. Y'all know what we say. That's it. That's all. Says the clock on the wall. Go be amazing on purpose. Don't forget that here we empower teachers to discover, develop, and utilize their superpowers to transform students' lives. It's not all about the teacher, y'all. Let's get it. All right. Y'all go be amazing on